Now, despite admitting that his country is in a struggle against a demon epidemic, Chinese President Xi Jinping has expressed confidence that China will win the battle against the coronavirus outbreak engulfing the world. Here's our Kim Hyo-sun with the details.
Meeting the Director General of the World Health Organization, who is in Beijing, President Xi Jinping projected an image of confidence and capability on Tuesday, saying his country can win its battle against a new coronavirus outbreak. Describing the epidemic as a demon, the Chinese leader said he will not let the demon hide. He also pledged that the Chinese government will be transparent.
Today I want to switch a little bit. And I'm wondering if we all are looking at this whole scenario of the COVID-19 from areas, or the various areas people are trying to tackle this thing. But I wonder if we go a little bit scriptural and see what a take you will receive from it. Because I think it's time that we take a look scripturally. I saw the other day where the Pentagon showed an image of a UFO. And it's an unknown. I saw it moving and it turned. What are these things? So with this intelligence we have, we should be able to pick up what that was. What still nobody knows. It was just placed out there. So guys, we got a lot of unknowns out there. I want to take you back in time. Let's go back to when things probably started. Now remember, I know that most people who are scientists and who follow the path of science seem to deviate away from religion. And I understand why, but that's not the forum today. I was one of those individuals who I grew up in a very Christian society. My parents were very much religious. And after going into science and so forth, I got distracted. And after lots of reading and searching and calling for the answer and the truth, I came all the way around back 360 and found God. I want to look at it today. Maybe we should look at it from a different... Yes, we know in the times past, we had a lot of plagues on the land, right? Whether it's locusts, plagues. This is not new. And you saw in my previous episodes that talked about all the various pandemics we've had. COVID-19 has placed mankind on its knees right now. And all of you looking, all of us looking on, this is new. We've not seen this before. We had recession 2008, yeah, but people moved back and forth. Businesses were, conducted. People were traveling. We got out of that. This one, the world is at a standstill. Everybody's just closing their borders. So you know how many people are going to be out of business? You know how many have been listening to the BBC this morning? And people were saying, they just said, listen, I've lost enough, I'm closing out. Not to this magnitude. And the last time we remember when we had the depression, 25% reduction in the GDP. You going into depression, or you may hear all kind of words. Recession, repression, depression, they all have their meanings. What does a famous guy said? He said, listen, when your neighbor has lost his job or her job, you're in a recession. When you lose your job, that's the depression. I think around 25 to 30% you drop off in the GDP universally. You're going into depression. We got a serious problems to turn this thing around. But as I said last week, right now is living and dying. We don't want to die. We want to really emerge. If we can find some type of herd immunity or some type of vaccine or some type of treatment or some type of cure, take care of this thing, then we deal with the finances. I told the patient the other day, a patient very, very sick, came to me and said, "Hey, doc," says, "man, you got a serious heart problem." And I says, "Right now, me, I try to preserve my health, because you can have all the money and all the stuff in the world. You take your health away, man, it means nothing to you." So today, let's go to the scripture and read. But remember, the beginning, man, there's a big war going on. Now, we ain't know nothing about it. Remember, we talking about this, the virus, that you got to look really under a real high magnification microscope to see this crong. Millions of them. When they come into your body, oh, they replicate so fast, man. And these guys, what's evading us is that they could, if you, like, for instance, they're doing a treatment right now, trying out something on a antacid type of medicine, famotidine. And that pill, they're saying, okay, if we can distract this virus, then we can achieve what we want. So we're treating this enemy as if it's really a real enemy, like we're fighting a war and anticipating what he or she would do. You got the troops over here, you distract them over there, and the guy's coming from the other side. So we're dealing with something really serious that's puzzling our scientists and our scientific community. So, Isaiah 14, verse 12 to 17, let me read that. "How art thou fallen from heaven, O Lucifer, son of the morning? How art thou cut down to the ground, which weakness the nations? For thou hast said in thine heart, I will ascend into heaven. I will exalt my throne above the stars of God," or the angels of God. "I will sit also upon the mount of the congregation in the sides of the north." Well, you know, Jesus, when he comes back, he's going to rule from the north. "I will ascend above the heights of the clouds," heavens. You know, we have three, the heavens, the first, second, and the third heavens. "I'll be like the Most High," like the Heavenly Father. "Yet thou shalt be brought down to hell, to the sides of the pit. They that see thee shall narrowly look upon thee and consider thee, saying, Is this the man that made the earth to tremble, that did shake kingdoms, that made the world as a wilderness, and destroyed the cities thereof, that opened not the house of his prisoners?" It's Lucifer. So we know that he was up there along with other angels, Michael, Raphael. They were there controlling in the second heavens, controlling there in charge of the angels. He was a beauty, morning star. But this guy just felt, well, listen, man, why, it's like what happened today. Oh, why God, why not me? Get a few guys, angels with him, and say I want to be like him or even more than him. The fight started up there. And he was cast down. But God didn't take all of his powers away from him. He didn't. That is why when Jesus was here and he came to save us, he could take Jesus up on the mountain and say, listen, hey, all of this, look at this, the kingdom, all of this was given to me. Bow down and worship me, I give this to you. Because it was given, wasn't taken away from him. Jesus rebuked him. So he's down here. There's a finite plan for this fella, Lucifer, Satan, the devil. There's a finite plan for him. But it's coming. You guys may have heard about the second coming of Christ. I can't do all in this one episode, but I just want to try to set up a stage for what I want to say. Let's move on to Ephesians 6, verse 12. And Jesus was with his disciples and was talking to them. And the Pharisees and the Sadducees they were talking a lot of stuff. They didn't believe him. And he said in verse 12, matter of fact, I should go back. I apologize. It's really, let me find it right here. It's the wrong scripture. This one right here. 6 verse 12. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. So Paul was talking about is a big fight going on here, guys. God and his angels, Jesus, God, his son, and the angels that were very much obedient to him, and the ones he cast down that were disobedient and followed Lucifer, which is really a third of the angels. But they're down here. Why don't we do one more? Matthew 11, 12. And Jesus was talking again to, as I said before, the disciples. He says, and from the days of John the Baptist until now, the kingdom of heaven suffered violence. It's spiritual. Remember, we're talking spiritual right now. You heard in the previous episode, we talk about the body, the soul, and the spirit, right? The spirit from God. The body here that can feel all the pain that we're living in. And the soul that, as Jesus said, fear not, he who can destroy the body. Come and stab me in my neck, hey, destroy the body. He said, you don't have to fear that guy. Fear he who can destroy both body and soul. That's the Heavenly Father we're talking about. So, read it again, starting again. And from the days of John the Baptist until now, the kingdom of heaven suffered violence. And the violent, that's Lucifer, take it by force. So he's down here. You remember when Jesus was going with his disciples And you see these two guys came up to him fierce. People couldn't pass by them. When they saw Jesus, they're possessed, of course. They say, oh, Son of God, what have we to do with thee? Why, you want to just get rid of us before our time? Because they know time is coming. God has a plan for the devil, his angels, and the people who he takes with him here. And you know what they say, suffer us to go in the swine. And Jesus let them go. So you see, swine went and got, they perished. But it tells you that the demons, Lucifer, and his angels that are really on this earth, causing a lot of destruction, they have to possess somebody, or else they roam in anguish, unhappy. They gotta get into somebody. Do you see a lot of those people killing? However, this Benoit, you know about the Canadian crippler, that wrestler, came in nice, doing well, successful wrestler, married and a couple of kids. You tell me that you, because your wife is gonna leave you, you're gonna go up and just coming one day, kill her, look at your young child, 6-7 years old, and shoot that child in the head. Who does that? Leave the children. The children, first of all, you kill nobody. Don't even kill yourself. Jump in a bus and say, hey, the driver say, hey, where you going, Benoit, where you going? He says, I don't care. I go where you go. You know what happened with time? You find somebody else and you move on with your life. It's a part of living. Pain, anguish, suffering, people betraying you, people hating you, all type of emotion, negativity, all of that stuff is a part of living. The day you don't have that stuff, you're dead. So live. Nothing should make you want to take somebody's life. Who died and make you boss that you could just take somebody's life? And you can imagine this other child comes, oh daddy, please daddy, oh daddy. Of course, the child saw what he did to mommy and the other child. Oh please, please. You just, that, tell me if that's a demon. Yes, I know. People get instant madness and things happen. But you premeditate that. Demon possession. So, can these, the devil right now is doing anything against what God wants. Because he knows his time is limited. It's like guys who got HIV, the HIV positive. Or guys out there who got some stuff. Community, whatever, some type of sexually transmitted disease. Ah, good eye, well, why not? I give it to 10, 15 people. I was in New York, I remember, years ago, as a resident in New York City. And there's these guys, when they got these drug addicts, and they, well, the drug addicts actually, they got infected. What do you think they did? They stand up at a stoplight. And if you got your hand outside, you're driving, they take a needle and stick you in their blood. It was happening. Some people are selfish, antisocial, and stuff like that. So that's the same thing the devil is doing right now. He wants company, man. You think he likes you? You think because he possess you and you could go over there and turn a snake into a bird, he likes you? He'll kill you. He has no mercy. What makes you think the devil is a nice guy? When Jesus says, hey, a good tree will bring forth good fruit, and an evil tree or thorn would gonna bring true bad fruit. Why you think an evil devil that knows he's got years of eternity banish into some abyss somewhere? Why you think he's gonna have mercy like you? What's special about you? He wants you to kill a couple of people. He wants you to blow up some station over there. Then he's laughing over. That's what he does. And then after that, all right, you go that way, I kill you. You have no, they'll die. That's what you may hear about Illuminati, but that's a different story again. We're not gonna go there. But they get taken eventually. Because it's evil. So I'm saying there's a big war going on between God, the Heavenly Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, the angels of the Lord, and all the people, all the hosts who are together with God against this villain that's here on earth. He's banished from up there. He can't go to the first heaven. He can't go to the second where he was before. And he can't go more to the third heaven, all above everything else where God dwells. Can't go. So havoc. So how do we know that, yeah, we are just players in this whole big scene? Yes, man special to God. Man, we in his image, he love us. So all right, you love them. That is why he did that to Adam and Eve. You love them. I'm gonna make sure you love the person you love the most. I'm gonna make it hard for you. Question, you say, hey Doc, wait a minute. Why didn't God take all the power away from Satan and Lucifer? Why allow him to do this stuff? I have to get back to you on that. Because I have a question. Yes, it could be choice. It could be all kind of stuff that God want to make us. Because angels don't have that. Angels in heaven, they don't have that choice. They just serve God. We his loved one. He gave us that choice to choose good and evil. So there's some questions there that I myself would have to delve into. The coronavirus now. How do we know that this is not a part of the whole evil? It's destroying God's people, man. People are dying. And we don't know what's happening. We don't. They say, all right, it come from bats and pangolins and all of these dogs and all this stuff that people consume. But when it checked the DNA on those, as a matter of fact, on the bats, it's different to the DNA and the coronavirus. So that's how they know it can't come directly from the bat to us. So I spare that lady who Chinese girl who was eating a bat and dipping the stupid meat in sauce. Didn't come directly because it's different. Has an intermediate host. And the pangolins, very close. Around 97 to 99%, similar to the coronavirus out there. That's why they're thinking it's that. And then I told you last week about now the dogs. They're fighting the gut of the dog. There's even a closer match. Even a closer match with the coronavirus right now that's infecting us. So a lot of unknowns, man. Every day it's changing. Got some guys out there who wants to become heroes, companies. Oh, they want to get a vaccine out there. The guy who gets the vaccine for this virus and cause a plateau and get this thing to go away, who will become a hero right away? You know how many tests gotta be passed to get there? Look, all right. For you guys who believe in evolution and stuff, I said a lot of things, and I prove it to you that evolution could not happen. But, as I said, you see the rhesus monkey? I did a little study in that. And when I was in college doing chemistry, I had to do a paper on the rhesus monkey. The closest animal to humans, the rhesus monkey. Think it's the rhesus macaque, I think. Yeah, macaque, yeah. The rhesus macaque is the monkey. Very close, 97% close to human DNA. They're doing some tests on them. And giving them some vaccination for a COVID. In the past, and it seems to, they're not getting sick when they expose them to the virus. But that's the animal study. How do we know when you inject that same vaccine into man, it's gonna work? It's a serious thing. You put a vaccine into someone, millions of people, and find out it caused some type of collateral problem, because some vaccine can cause a lot of infection. Some vaccines given to immunocompromised people, problems. Vaccine can be given to older people. All of those things cause the immune response is blunted. There's a lot of problems, and it takes months. They have vaccines for SARS-1. They say that they have that. And wonder if they can try it out on COVID-19 and see if it's going to work. All of these options. Remdesivir, we talked about last week. Hydroxychloroquine, all of those treatments. But one, you got to find out what this guy is about. And the coronavirus is evading people. If there's a possibility of 5 strains, how are you going to find a vaccine in a couple of months? How are you going to do that? Doesn't happen. So many trials got to happen. You got to try it on this and that. You got to, there's stages, phase 1, phase 2, phase 3, before you come out with something. What happens in the meantime? So the vaccine is to prevent it from coming in and infected you. The treatment, as we said, all those mentioned, remdesivir, and we talked about hydrochloroquine and some treatment there out there. So they're trying the other one they call famotidine and so forth, the antacid and so forth. We're trying a lot of things. And then after that, how about the people who've been in the ventilator? They can't remember their names. You would see that it's okay. 3 million people infected. And yes, 1 million something recovered. What happened to the rest? You know how many people are in nursing homes? Can't walk, can't. Come on, man. You're ventilated for 2 weeks. You got a problem when you come out of there. Remember, it's hypoxia. When these patients present, they present like high altitude sickness with a lot of fluid in the lung. They're gasping for air, again, like suffocating. You have decreased oxygen to your brain, man. You lose brain cells. So even when you come back, premature Alzheimer, can't walk, all kind of stuff. A lot of these people are now going to be placed in nursing homes, and you got a resurgence of this thing. We got a problem. Serious problem. But as I said, it's going on, and all of this could be evil. Why not? The evil one is out there, running to and fro, looking to see what he can do. Ladies and gentlemen, we're in some serious times. The world is on a halt right now, and over a month, it's probably going to 2 months, some place will open up and some will go until July, some may go till almost the end of the year. the airline's bankruptcy going on. Millions of people are losing their jobs. The cruise industry is like gone. Because I tell you see the fare factor I told you about last week? That's a serious threat. Because even, which I don't think will happen, this thing is not going away this year. No, it's not going away this year. But let's say a miracle happens and it should go away by September. The fear factor is going to blunt any type of increase in economic gains. Who's going to want to go on a cruise? Not me. Who's going to want to fly from here to San Francisco? If I fly, I might use a hazmat suit. Hey, you're worried. What, could you catch this thing? So, it's aftermath. The aftermath is what's going to cause a lot of problems, guys. As I said, we need to be calm and relax because it happened before. In the past, and now with such real state-of-the-art technology, we might be able to, instead of the 2 to 4 years normally a pandemic would last, we might be able to cut back on the time. Yeah, because of all the stuff we have going on right now. Science moves leaps and bounds. If this had happened 100 years ago, I'm telling you, it might have wiped out half of the world. We're fighting this very small enemy. And you know, we have to do as the authorities say. Social distancing, be safe, wash your hands, do all the stuff that they're talking about. And if people are going back out to work, you still gotta be safe. Look, I'm in the work, I gotta be washing my hands, I gotta be wearing my mask, I gotta be, I meet my patients, you gotta be doing that, or bowing and those type of things. It's very uncomfortable. But we gotta do it until we get a grip of this thing. But I just wanna open your eyes a little to think all of this is happening, what part the spiritual realm has to do with it. What part does Lucifer to do this thing? God normally don't give us, don't destroy me. He doesn't do that. He's a loving God. He may sit back and allow certain things to happen. But no, he's not going to do that. Destroy us like that. We've got a time he wants us to learn of him. He wants us, because he loves us, man. We look like him. Matter of fact, Jesus was from Asia, you know. I got you in that one, didn't I? Yeah. There are more Asians in this world than anybody else. 1.4 billion Asians. 1.3 billion Indians. After that, you got the Americans. 330 million. And then you may have Indonesia and so forth. So, Asia, Israel, they're called Asians. They are as a part of Asia. Yeah. So lots of things comes out of Asia. So we don't know. We don't know what's happening. What I do know, what is happening is not good. And the master of evil, Lucifer, probably has a big part to play in this. Don't have a vaccine yet. Don't have any real treatment yet. Still have to go through the aftercare for these patients. That ventilator ain't doing much. Because a lot of people go on ventilators and die. Because the doctors are not accustomed to that. Yes. They're accustomed to seeing infection, severe acute respiratory syndrome from bacteria. And when the bacteria come into your body and in the lung, and then it goes septic and go into your whole, your veins and your arteries, your blood system, we give you strong antibiotics. Kill them. Because I told you we have greater control over bacteria. Kill them. And then you start to recover. And you come in with these, with the COVID-19, first of all, you come in late. Because everybody's thinking right now it's in the hospitals. Hey, the COVID is in the hospital, I ain't going there. EMT, they go and pick up all these COVID bitches, I ain't going in no ambulance. Let me stay here and take my chances. And when they can't breathe, cause it looks like altitude sickness where the fluid just go in your lung, man. You get it. Then they go, but by then you put them in a ventilator. When you finish, man, you got some time a comatose person or somebody who doesn't know how to count. If they make it. So it's really a serious, serious problem. And as I said before, Lucifer might be a part of this. We don't know where this thing is going. And I don't think it's the end of the world. No, it is not. Because when the end comes, you ain't gonna know. Sudden, you ain't gonna know. But all of these things the scripture talked about, the end times, what will happen. Guys, uncertain, we don't know what's gonna happen next year. We're gonna have new normals. All of this niceties we had will be taken away from us. Workforce, everything will be different. But we have to move with the changes of the times. We will overcome this one. But I don't know what next year and the year to come and the year after, what it holds. I don't know where we'll be. So maybe this is the time we should sit down. It could be a test that we should go down on our knees. Because we think that we own everything. This earth belongs to us. We forget God. And we think that, hey man, no, we are so much, we got so much brain power out there. We got complete control. But the swiftness of this thing tells us, put us in check. In 6 weeks. 6 weeks, look what happened. Look at the change. This is wild. 6 weeks, look what happened. It's like a guy rising up in politics, working hard from since a kid, get to the top. And you get to the top like I heard about a governor the other day. Well, a guy who run for a governor the other day made a mistake and got in a fight with his girlfriend. Back down to the bottom, fall like right away. Things can happen right away. Suddenly, take your whole life to get up there. Maybe it's the time for us to sit down and look at it from a spiritual point of view and pray and ask God, the Heavenly Father, for a way out of this thing. Only He knows. He's made us. He knows how to fix this thing, you know. Boy, I wish we had the immune system of the bats. They got a super immune system. That is why this virus can hang out in them. Super immune system, actually. The bats? They develop, they can live for 20 years to 40 years. Because remember they say, with size, as you get smaller, your lifespan is shorter. Not with the bats, bats defy that. 20 to 40 years they can live. Super immune system, these viruses and stuff, they carry a lot of them as carriers. Can't infect them. Just real fast, get rid of it. If we had that, nothing like this would be around. We don't. Let's sit down and rethink this thing. You may not believe in God. You may not believe in the Heavenly Father. But sit down. Look into His Word. This Word here can't lie, man. This Word here, boy, is consistent. This Word here, I watched the translations and a few of them well. Oh yeah, you can't touch the Word. God don't speak to man anymore. Spoke to man first. Man and listen. Send a son. We killed him. Now, the Holy Ghost is here. No more speaking until judgment. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to encourage you to use this time in your home to find peace with God. Ask Jesus to come into your life, show you the way. He will. Ask Him, tell Him you'd like to know. He'll show you. This contrite heart, you have it. Just be open-minded. The Holy Spirit will show you the way. May God bless you. And as I always say, I'll see you next week. Love the Lord. Say your prayers. Take your vitamins. This is Dr. Alfred Sparkman.